reporter Rob Roblin joins us live in Edgewood in Harford County, where disaster relief efforts are underway. Robbie.
Well, the biggest problem up here, downed trees. And a lot of those trees fell on power lines. So there, in turn, you have a lot of people up here without power during the storm.
Just the crushing and just the impact, it's hard to describe. But it didn't form several to be going down like that, striking houses as they went down. It was just, I never want to hear another sound like that again.
Lee Edwards was talking about the tree that fell on his neighbor's house Monday night. That house belongs to Helen Murray, and this morning she saw the damage for the first time.
I really was shocked when I saw it, and I know you can rebuild and material things are important, but I'm very grateful to God that I was not in the house at the time.
All over Harford County, there were trees down, minor flooding, and lots of power outages.
Just waiting for the electricity to go on, and then we'll be in good shape. But everything's taken care of, and we've had a lot of help from our neighbors, so that's been a big help. Everybody pitches in together, gets things cleaned up.
If you're in the tree trimming business, there will be plenty of work for weeks.
How many calls are you getting? Are they like constantly?
Yes, sir. Yeah, all the time. One after another. Matter of fact, I'm going to go look at jobs after we get this cleaned up.
Over at the Harford County Emergency Management Center, they were winding down. It's been a very busy few days. But Bob Thomas with the county government says it could have been a lot worse.
When you look at what's happened to New Jersey, when you look at what happened in New York and other jurisdictions, Harford County and the great state of Maryland fared much better than these other jurisdictions.
Now, BGE reports that they have restored power here in Harford County to over 58,000 customers, but a little over 8,000 customers are still without power at this hour. Reporting live, Rob Roblin, WBAL-TV 11 News.
All right, Robbie, thank you very much.